Nawaz Modi Singhania is someone who comes with more than 25 years of experience in fitness and nutrition. Well, she does give us ideas, advices and suggestions on how we can improve our health and lifestyle. So much so that she has enough and more fitness routines for senior citizens to ensure that they are not leading an ailing life. That is, I think, so much helpful and so much needed. Well, today she's going to talk about and focus on emotional stress, something that takes away so much of our life and the quality of the life we lead. How to kind of de-stress yourselves and how exercise can contribute in a very, very big way. It's a special I do every Thursday. It's called Get Healthy with Annie. So I'm slipping into an ad space, a few songs, and we'll come right back with her.
This is Mumbai On Demand with Annie.
It's a Thursday, back to Get Healthy with my fitness expert, Nawaz Modi Singhania, founder, director of Body Art Fitness Studio. Welcome back.
Hey, Annie. Thank you.
And now that you've had a good vacation, and we also talked about how to kind of keep our fitness levels going throughout the monsoon, even if it is raining outside, you've given us a few tips how we can, you know, really go about not missing it. And now we are moving to emotional stress. Emotional stress is something that affects us in, I think, our day-to-day lives. It's something that we see not only in India, but across the world. There are various, I think, categories now of emotional stress, because there's depression. There is, other than depression, there are many other mental disorders. Tell us about it.
You know, with our lifestyles becoming more and more secluded, life becoming more and more competitive, busy, relationships being more strained, us becoming more intolerant, especially abroad, kids move out that early. Mm. Their lives are very independent and very lonely. It's so competitive out there that increasingly depression is a huge issue.
Right.
Suicide rates are at an all-time high, and it's a major problem out there.
Mm.
And the good news is that exercise, amongst other things, counters depression. So it actually increases the happy hormones, you know, physically, chemically. So happy hormones such as serotonins, dopamines, endorphins are actually increased. And exercise is actively used as an antidepressant as well.
Wow. You know, when it comes to stress of various kinds, like you rightly pointed out, that it is our lifestyle that raises most of the issues. And then it becomes very difficult to kind of face it. You're saying exercise is one thing. But right in the beginning, you touched upon this even when we were doing personality development, where you spoke about how, you know, it is very important to love yourself and to keep oneself in a situation and surrounding where you know that there's always positive factors around you. These things also contribute to stress, right? Or rather help you come off stress.
Yes, absolutely, hugely. Not to mention that aside from exercise countering, you know, depression in the way I just described, obviously when you're exercising, you are fitter, you're slimmer, you're more toned, you look better, you look younger, you feel better, you engage better with people in the world, they treat you better, and all these things are obviously going to help you feel better in toto. So it counters any sort of negativity, any sort of depression which you're harboring in any case. So it's very holistic, the approach.
Right. So we're going to slip into an ad break in a few songs and come right back to talk about a few steps objectively that we can actually inculcate to inculcate a positive surrounding. And that way, I think we can beat emotional stress and depression and whatever other mental disorders these days we see. This is Get Healthy with Nawaz Modi Singhania on Mumbai On Demand with me, Annie. Just like Nawaz rightly pointed out, now this is Get Healthy, I do every Thursday with an intention to kind of try and help me and my listener out with the day-to-day issues when it comes to varied number of things that has to do with our health. So it starts from fitness, exercise, how disciplined we are, to our personality development, to the positive environment we're supposed to be in, and then how to fight the negativity around. So emotional stress is what we're talking about today, which leads to depression and various other mental disorders. Exercise, Nawaz pointed out, can be of great help to sort everything out. Nawaz, if we have to objectively take it step by step, how can one go about it?
Well, Annie, the best exercises to counter depression are cardio exercises, as opposed to, for instance, toning or strength training or resistance training of sorts, or as opposed to stretching.
Okay.
You know, those categories. So coming back to the cardio part of it, exercises like walking, partaking in an aerobic class, a dance class, jumping, skipping, stair climbing, swimming. These are all cardio activities.
Right.
Basically activities where you're, that's why it's called cardiorespiratory, activities where you're pumping, your heart is pumping, your respiratory system is involved.
Right.
And these are ideal in countering depression of sorts.
Right.
Take on whatever you like, take on whatever you enjoy, change it frequently, yes, just get on your way. At this point in time, you may find outdoor cycling, walking, etc., not possible. Take on indoor activities. There are ample to choose from.
All right. And I think at Body Art, you do offer ample of these opportunities to, you know, try out different cardiovascular activities. Can you take us through some of them?
Yes, sure. So our aerobic workshop, for instance, is about 25 different types of group classes that are conducted.
Wow.
A lot of them are cardio. So, for instance, things like box aerobics or step aerobics, a new body format where you're working out with light weights and it's a cardio activity. Mm-hmm. Activities like Zumba, Bollywood, dance of varying sorts. You've got trampoline workouts, slide training workouts, circuit training. There's a lot happening out there. There's a lot to choose from and a lot to keep you very interested in. And it's important from time to time to vary your routine as well so that you don't get into a lull, both physically and you don't see the result thereafter, or mentally and emotionally.
Absolutely.
Separate that from your physicality. So you've got to make sure that you're happy in toto.
Yeah. Can you share your handles one more time with us?
Right. For our social media handles, Instagram is Nawaz Body Art Mumbai.
Mm-hmm.
Facebook, Body Art India. YouTube, Body Art Mumbai. And our website, bodyart.in, IN for India.
There it is, bodyart.in. You'll find all the details. And yes, they are spreading across the city. Many centers coming up very soon. That again, you will be updated on the website. Thank you so much for today, Nawaz.
Thank you, Annie. My pleasure.
And I'm going to catch you next week, same time.